Subscriber, now we are in the class 7 of the first part of this lesson. So the lesson is data handling, and in this lesson we are going to have the introduction of mean and the range, and then we will jump on the exercise part. So here in the introduction part of the lesson we will see what is arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean is also known as an average. So it is calculated as sum of all observation upon number of observation. Example, a batsman score the numbers. Batsman score the following numbers of runs in 6 innings. Calculate the mean. You can say calculate the average run score by him in an innings. So you have to just do the total. How to calculate total, that you already know. So here your total is 282. You have to divide by number of observation. Here this is sum of observation and this is number of observation. So how many observation? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's why we divided this by 6 and you are getting the answer 47. It means the run score in the inning are 47. So 47 is the average. Okay, you can say in average is score 47 run. So whatever the answer will come, it is sure it should be more than the less value, and the it should be less than the greater value. So here we are getting 47. You observe it is in between that. Your result means whatever the answer is getting, you are getting, you can cross check also. You must have the idea what answer you will get. So that is the expected answer, and we got the answer 47, and this is the formula of the calculation. Next one is, in the think, discuss and write part, mean lies in between the greatest and the smallest number. As I told you, you have to assume the greater value of the less number, and the you can say the less value of the greater number. And as a accuracy is, mean lies in between greater and the smallest observation. It is the between value, you can say. So here for example, the average of 5 and 11, you have to do their addition. Number of observations are 2 divided by 2, it is 8. So this is 8 is a middle value which lies between 5 and 11. So in 5 and 11, you know the middle value is 8. Okay. So the answer is 8. This particular concept of average, it is also used to find the middle value of two number, to find the middle value of two fraction. So for that case, you can use the average concept also. Now we will see range. The difference between the highest and lowest observation give us idea about the range. So in the range, the ages in years of 10 teacher of school. This is the ages of the school. What is the age of oldest and the youngest teacher? So here first, whenever you calculate, you arrange the number in ascending order, and so that you can get the age of youngest and the age of oldest. So here oldest is 54 and the youngest is 23. Okay, now in the second part, the range of the ages are greater value, smaller value and the difference. So that is what the range. Whenever you get the range, you have to, it is better if you put the number in ascending order so that you can get the smallest and largest value. And the range formula is highest value minus smallest value. That is what the range. Now we jump on exercise. First question of your exercise, find the range of height of any 10 student of your class. This answer is varied from one student to another student. I am taking one table. Here in this table, name of the 10 student and their height is there. So according to this table, if you are calculating the range, highest value minus lowest value means highest height, lowest height. So highest height is 5.3 and the lowest is 4.2. So it means your answer is 1.1. Here the unit is feet. If it is centimeter, you give centimeter. So range formula is very simple. Highest value minus the smallest. ऑर्गेनाइज द फॉलोइंग मार्क्स इन अ क्लास असेसमेंट इन ट्यूबुलर फॉर्म. सो हियर सम नंबर्स हैव बीन गिवन एंड यू शुड फर्स्ट अरेंज इन ट्यूबुलर फॉर्म. विच नंबर इज हाइएस्ट, विच नंबर इज लोवेस्ट, यू कैन इजिली फाइंड. वॉट इज द रेंज दैट यू रिसेंटली लर्न एंड फाइंड द अरिथमेटिक मीन मीन्स एवरेज. सो हियर आई हैव डन विद द टेबल. दिस इज द ट्यूबुलर फॉर्म, दीज आर द मार्क्स. सो एज इन द क्वेश्चन वी गॉट द मार्क्स लाइक दैट, सो आई जस्ट अरेंज लाइक दैट. दिस मार्क्स इज नथिंग बट एक्स आई, ओके, दीज आर द मार्क्स. देन टैली मार्क्स मीन्स हाउ मेनी टाइम्स दे आर देयर. सो वन इज देयर इन दिस लिस्ट वन टाइम, सो वन लाइन. टू इज देयर टू टाइम, दिस इज वन टाइम टू. एंड वन मोर टाइम टू इज देयर हियर, दिस इज द वन, दिस इज टू. सो आई यूज टू लाइन. थ्री इज देयर वन टाइम, सो वन लाइन. फोर इज देयर थ्री टाइम. फाइव इज देयर फाइव टाइम. सो इफ यू आर राइटिंग फाइव, फोर वर्टिकल लाइन एंड वन क्रॉस लाइन. इफ सिक्स इज देयर देन यू राइट हियर सिक्स, ओके. सिक्स मीन्स नंबर ऑफ लाइन्स यू हैव टू ड्रॉ. वन टू थ्री फोर, इट इज फोर टाइम. सेवन इज टू टाइम. एट इज वन टाइम. नाइन इज वन टाइम. देन इट मीन्स फ्रीक्वेंसी मीन्स नंबर ऑफ टाइम. सो हियर वन लाइन मीन्स वन टाइम. टू लाइन मीन्स टू लाइन. थ्री मीन्स थ्री टाइम, ओके. सो दिस इज वॉट द टैली मार्क एंड दिस इज वॉट द फ्रीक्वेंसी मीन्स नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स. सो यू कैन डू देयर एडिशन. दिस इज द एडिशन ऑफ सम, सम ऑफ दिस वैल्यू वेरिएबल एफ आई. यू कैन टेक एनी वेरिएबल. फ्रीक्वेंसी मीन्स मीनिंग ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी इज नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स. यू कैन यूज एनी वेरिएबल. सो हियर आई यूज एफ आई. सो इट्स सम इज 20. एंड हियर आई यूज वन फॉर्मूला, मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ दिस एंड मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ एक्स आई वैल्यू. सो देयर मल्टीप्लीकेशन कम. This one is their multiplication and finally their sum is 100 because in average it is going to use. So here in this table, according to your first question, highest value is 9, okay. You see here highest value is 9, lowest value is 1. Range is 9 minus 1, 8 and mean means sum of values means fi into xi. So here the sum of value, because number 1 it is 1 times, so 1. 2 is 2 times, so their sum is 4. 3 is 1 time, so their sum is 3. And 4 is there 3 times, so their sum is 12. So finally we have done their total sum 100. And number of observations, so here frequency means number of observation, that is 20. So divide this by 20, answer is 5. So here the mean of this number is 5. So you see here 5, it is in between 1 and 9. So here arithmetic mean is 5. Exercise 3.1, question number 3. Find the mean of first 5 whole number. So the whole numbers, they are like that 0, it start with the 0. And how you will find the mean? Addition of all these observation divided by total value are 5. So this is the formula and you have to write all the value which is divided by 5. So 10 by 5 is 2. So the answer is 2. Required mean is 2. Question number 4. Cricketer score the following runs. Find the mean score. Again you do the addition of all value and total observations are 3, 3, 6 plus 2, 8. So you see total observations 8, so addition is 400 divided by 8 and answer is your 50. So the mean score is 50. Following table shows the point of each player score in 4 games. So here some questions have been given. You have to determine the A average, then average of C. B played in all 4 games, so how would you find the mean? Who is the best performer? That thing you have to find. So first part, find the, determine the A's average. How you will get A's average? All these values divided by 4. So we will see that sum of all square and number of game played. So as I told you, sum of all these value divided by 4, answer is 12.5. Then second part, find the mean number of points per game for C. Would you divide the total point by 3 or 4? In case of C, he played only 3 games. So you have to calculate the average of these three games, not the four. So it is divided by three. So C didn't play game third. So he played only three games. So total will be divided by three. Then third part, B played in all the four games. How would you find the mean? So B means all the four game divided by 4 means 0 plus 8 plus 6 plus 4 divided by 4. So here this is the sum divided by 4. So answer is 4.5. Who is the best performer? So whatever the average you calculated, you compare that and you find whichever value is greater, that person will be a best performer. So 12.5. A got definitely best score, so his average will be more. So the best performer of the game is A because his average is more. Then question number 6, the mark obtained by group of students in the test are. So the marks have been given and find the highest and lowest mark. You can easily calculate range also and then mean. So arrange the mark in ascending order that we arrange now. And then highest and lowest, you can easily calculate highest is 95 and the lowest is 39. Range means 95 minus 39, it is 56. Third one, you have to calculate mean, means the addition of all the value divided by number of observation 10. You do the calculation, answer will be 73. Question number 7. Here during the 6 consecutive years was as follow. This is the enrollment of the school. Find the mean enrollment of the school. So addition of all the values divided by 6. So 2058 is the mean value and this is the answer of this question. Question number 8. The rainfall on 7 day of certain week was recorded as follow. Find the range, find the mean and on how many day was the rainfall less than the mean value. First one is find the range. Range means highest value minus smallest value. So here the greatest value is 20.5 and the lowest is 0.0. So range is 20.5 minus 0. So it is 20.5 and the unit of this is mm. And then second one, you have to find the average. So addition of all the value divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You divide this by 7, you will get the answer 5.9. mm. And then for the third part, on how many days was the rainfall less than mean value, means less than 5.9. so less than 5.9 means this value is less, this value is less, this value is less, again this value is less and this value is less. So you can write there a day, Monday I already told you, then Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday and Sunday, it is 1.0. so rainfall, they are less than the mean value. 9. The height of 10 girls were measured in centimeter. What is the height of tallest and the shortest girl? First you do it in ascending order, all the number, and then you can easily calculate the height of tallest girl and the height of shortest girl. If you don't do the number in ascending order, that is also okay, but if you put all the number in ascending order, there is no chances of doing mistake. So when you solve that, you have to keep all the number in ascending order so that you can easily pick up the smallest and largest number. The range is highest value and the lowest value. You will get the range 23 because the greatest value is 151, smallest value is 128. Then next one is fourth one, you have to find mean, means the addition of all the value divided by 10 because total values are 10 and you get the answer here divided by 10 is 141.4 centimeter. Fifth one, how many girls height it is a more than average value, more than mean value, means our average is 141.4. so these all the values are greater than 141.4. so these are the values, these are more than the mean value. So this is the answer of all the question and I hope friend you understood that, and I suggest you practice in rough paper so that you can do the calculation also and you can understand in better way. So thanks for watching this. Thank you.